Welcome back to another episode of Farming Simulator 2015 with the Rude Man. And everything that was old is new again. In the last episode, I thought I had version... Somebody pointed out that I wasn't playing the latest version. I went and got what I thought was the latest version. Because it said 3.4. But 3.4 is still version 3. And I just, for some reason, assumed 3.4 was the 4 that people were talking about, version 4. Well, I was wrong. So, well, I started the whole farm over again from scratch to try to get caught up to where I was. And I actually made another episode after that one before somebody else told me, you're still not on version 4. Because, well, as it turns out, the silo in the South Farm wasn't working. And I asked the question, is anybody else having trouble with this silo not working? And one of my subscribers sent me a comment and said, it doesn't work because it's an older version. You need to be on 4. And so I went out and found 4. I'm now on 4. And there's quite a few changes. Some of them I'm curious about, but I'll show you what I'm talking about. So, let's see here. I did start all over again. I haven't caught up yet. I'm trying to catch up to where I left off, but I've got a pretty good start on it. And I'm just tired of playing by myself. I wanted to come on and record and play with you guys. Am I stuck in the ground, or... I wish you could see your body, because I look like I'm right on the ground. Oh, well, maybe it's an opticlaw illusion. All right, well, anyway, there's been quite a few changes. Some of them are obvious, some of them aren't. The first one that is a heartbreaker to me, well, it's not a heartbreaker, but it's going to be a challenge, is the fact that they put damage mod in. You guys have seen me drive, right? Well... I'm going to have a little bit of trouble. The other problem with the damage mod, it's not a problem. Like I said, it's a challenge. And I know Stevie probably put this in just because of the way I drive. He probably couldn't stand the fact that I was smashing my rigs into everything and had no consequences. So he's punishing me. Here's the only issue I have with the damage mod, and it's not really an issue. Again, it's a challenge. And that is that there's only one place to repair anything. I have tons of equipment, and if you look in the lower left corner, down on the bottom, you'll see where it tells me how much damage each piece of equipment has. I've just been normal farming, and I haven't done anything crazy. I've tried very hard not to mess up my equipment. But as you can see, just from normal use, this stuff gets banged up, and there's only one place to repair, and it doesn't happen instantly. So this is a brand new truck. This is the newer version of the Superman. The one I had wasn't very good. So I'll see. It's still got 9% damage on it. It's been sitting there for an hour. But let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm going to grab my pickup truck through just driving. My pickup truck has got 27% damage on it. I'm thinking in my mind that it doesn't necessarily represent damage. It represents wear and tear. You got to change the oil. You got to have the tires rotated. You know, that kind of thing. So I have a problem with the damage. It's just like in the trucking simulator games. Everything is damaged. There's no in-between. Well, yes, if you smash into another car, you're going to have damage. I'm talking the truck simulator now. If you have an accident, you're going to have damage. If you don't watch what you're doing and you run into a building, you're going to do damage. But just from safe driving from, you know, one destination to another that might be 600-700 miles, you're going to have wear and tear and oil changes and stuff like that. That's also represented in there, but they call it damage. So I think they should change that. It's just, you know, and well, we'll talk about that in a minute. So anyway, so what you do is you hit the R button or R key and it starts. Now look, it's down to 25, down to 24. This is going to take forever. So I'm going to have, my equipment's going to be lined up here all the time to be repaired in between. It's going to take me hours to repair all this stuff. And all I've been doing is just normal wear and tear. I tell you the one that really gets the wear and tear, and that's the cultivator. Let me find my cultivator. Yeah, look at my cultivator. All I did was cultivate fields, and I've got 61% damage on this thing. Let's see, what's this one? Yeah, this one's not too bad, but I started out with just one. Oh, by the way, you've noticed I changed cultivators. That one was just retarded. It didn't cost any money. It was 50 meters wide. It was completely bogus. I mean, you know, and it didn't do, in my opinion, that good a job. All it did really was, you know, one or two swipes and your field was done. Now, if I really didn't like that, I could go back to my old seeder that you didn't have to cultivate with. You just, you know, you just took the seeder out and it seeded the fields. The only problem was that it, that particular one did not fertilize. It just seeded. Now, they do have some out there. As a matter of fact, they have the ones that I use that that do everything. But I don't know. I like the one I use. It just means that I have to cultivate. Pardon me, I took a sip of tea. Anyway, so I need to get to work. But I wanted to kind of go over some of the things in this map. So let me see if my pickup's done yet. Okay, it's done. And it tells you when it's done. That's a good thing too. I like that. So Stevie, don't get me wrong. I like it. It's just going to be a challenge for me. And I want to talk about Stevie for a minute because this is his map. I love the guy. His maps are great. But I have to wonder. I don't think he watches me. I don't know if he does or not. But here's something that's interesting, I thought, anyway. When I first started playing this map, and he started adding things like the lettuce and cabbage and tomato farms, I made a comment about the fact that that you used grain seeds to seed. How does wheat turn into cabbage and that kind of thing? How does that happen? Just curious. I mean, I don't really care. It's part of the game. But you pour wheat in that thing, or barley, wheat or barley, and you get cabbage, lettuce, tomatoes, whatever the hothouse is making at the time. And I just made a comment that that's kind of weird. Okay, so that was one thing. Well, he's fixed it now. If you notice over here, we have a Seedmaster umpteen thousand over here, bright orange, that makes painted seeds. And that makes more sense. So you put something in there, which is, happens to be wheat or barley, and that's fine. You stick that in there, and it makes seeds. And so it's a little bit more, I don't know, I don't want to say realistic, immersive maybe. So now you have to make your seeds to put in there, and I think that's great. I like that. The other thing was, I came over here, and again, I don't know if Stevie watches my videos or even knows I exist, but I made a comment also that why is the water gray and the fertilizer is blue? Now, gas red, that makes sense. Red, fire, explosions, you know, danger, Will Robinson, that kind of thing. And so now I get back in this farm, version 4, and water is blue and fertilizer is gray. And that makes more sense to me. Because I kept pulling up to the wrong one. I kept pulling up to blue to get water and I'd get fertilizer. And then I'd think, oh yeah, okay, gray is water. And I'm an RVer, I have a fifth wheel. Gray water means dirty water. Your gray water is your dishwater, the water that you use in a sink, and it may have soap and detergent in it because you've washed your hands, and it's dirty water. Okay, then they have potable water, which is the water you put in a tank for your drinking water. And then, of course, they have the black water, which is your sewer. Okay, so I'd run up to get water, and I'd say, okay, we're getting dirty water here because it's gray. So anyway, that's changed now, so that's kind of cool. And there's some more changes that are kind of cool. I like cool things. I'm a gadget guy. I tell you what really tickled me, and that is some of the water troughs. They're just, I really like them. I got to try not to hit a tree or anything else. And I'm afraid that little dip I just made on the hill is going to cause damage in my truck. Stevie, you're killing me. Anyway, I got to learn to drive respectably now. Let's see here. Yeah, some things have moved around. The Seedmaster thing has moved. If you notice now, he's got the bulletin board style counters of what you've got in fruit. So it's all in one place, and you can see it when you're unloading. I like that. Instead of having to go and look at each bin, each silo. Cool. I like it. There's probably some stuff I haven't even found yet because I've been so busy trying to get my farm back to where it was. I've got all the animals purchased. I've got, I think I've got water and all that kind of stuff going for the animals. I need to feed them some things. Some things I have. I'm waiting for my silage to be done so I can start the mixing station. I have collected quite a bit of straw. I've got potatoes. Talking about potatoes, let's talk about beets. You know, if you've noticed, I don't usually do beets. I haven't ever seen a reason to, but there might be a reason to do beets now. Two reasons. One, on this farm, there's some ways of making money with the beet pulp and stuff like that. So I know this thing's over here. I've never used it. I've been too busy, to be honest with you, because I lie to you every other time. So we have this thing here. I can start using that if I had beets. And so that's one reason. Here's the other reason. And I'm curious about beets. Does that constitute compost? Because I need compost for my, what do I need compost for? The fruit. The fruit. All right, so anyway, enough of that. Let's go down and take a look here at this farm. The big change that I could see was, and I might have mentioned this in the last episode, but was the potato washers. Oh, there's some compost I can use right there. This one just washes the potatoes. That one over there steams them. So I can use the steamed potatoes for pig forage, and I can sell the washed potatoes or whatever I want to do with them. These silos or bunkers or whatever you want to call them have moved. This makes more sense to me. They're localized. You can drive down one side and down the other, and you know everything's right here. Your potatoes, your beets, you know, your grass, your silage, your all that junk is all right there. That makes a lot of sense. I like that. This field here was extended. It was widened. He widened it by about this much right here to the right. That's all new. So there's a little bit more property there. I had to reset my course play. And let's see, what else have we got that's different? I think this is all the same. Yeah, see, I've got potatoes. I've got the earth fruits in there. I think that hothouse was in the last episode. I haven't used it yet. But let me show you another thing that I was talking. And again, I haven't driven the whole map, so I don't know if there's anything else that's new. but I want to show you something that just tickled the heck out of me. Let me see if I can find it. Let me find my water whatcha-dinger. Oh, what was he doing? He was repaired. I'm just curious why I had him sitting there for an hour and he still has 9% on him. Let me pull him in here. Can I do this while I'm standing up? Alright, let's see. Well, it's showing 9% damage. Do I have to be out of the rig and standing over there? No, there it goes. Oh, I do have to be standing in there. Okay. Alright, I'm going to see if I can fix that other 9%. So, let me find my water tank. Yeah, I screwed up when I bought those trucks, too. This one is the right color for... This is the new Superman. It's the a later version than the one I had. But I made that one orange instead of kind of yellowish, but that's okay. I'm leaving it. Let me find my water tank. I'm going to show you something just tickle the snot out of me. There it is. All right. Let me get rid of that. And there's no water in it. Let's go find some water. It runs better if you start it. All right. Now, where in the heck am I? All right. Okay, yeah, there. It finally fixed it. You know what happened is I think I restarted my game and it wasn't quite finished. That's what I think. If I'm wrong, sue me. All right, let's get some water here. I thought this was so cool. I don't know if it's gonna work. I might have to go back to the sheep. You know how when you pull up to some of the things and a pipe comes out of this tanker and hooks up to a spigot? I think that's so cool. Well, my tea was too hot, now it's too cold. Well, not really. It's just lukewarm. All right, let me see here. I'm going to go in to the cows. And I don't think I've given them water. I need to give them... did I give them straw? I think so. Nope, I need to give them straw. Let me get up here and see. Open up. Let me in. Open up. Yeah. This one's got it. All right, this is cool. This one just made me giggle. It was so cool. Yeah, I know I'm a geek. Or nerd, or whatever the term is nowadays. All right, watch this. This is cool. If I can find the trigger here. All right, there's the trigger. Okay, now ready? Ready? Alright, I'm gonna hit the trigger. Look at that, look at that. Look at the water come out. Isn't that cool? I love that. I just started giggling when I saw that. I thought, oh man, that's so cool. Yeah, I know, it's the little things in life. Okay, well, let me get this guy back to the farm. I've gotta get some, I gotta get the crops ready to harvest. I'm still trying to get caught up. I want to do some... I used all my chaff and it was too late. I had already reseeded, so I didn't reseed any more crops for chaff. But let me go... What do I want to do first? First of all, I want to get that... I've got to get this, let me get this out of the way. I got to get that cultivator starting to repair, or it's going to take all day. So let's get this guy back to the farm. Yeah, I'm going to be repairing equipment all the time. And I wish that there was a maintenance thing in your farm. You know, a big barn with one of those things in it, so you could start. There should be one in each farm, because I'm gonna have to drive all of my equipment all the way to the shop And, you know, that'd be kind of handy if there was, like, one of those barns, like that one back there, if it had a repair shop in it or something, I don't know. Let me see if I can get in here. I got to be careful with these trucks because they're so damn fast that I'm going to end up running into something. I'm already smashed into that trailer there. I think that's how my truck got damaged. I came racing in here and I couldn't stop it in time. And I hit that trailer in front of me. Alright, I'm going to... Yeah, see, it took damage just hooking it up. Not really, I'm just kidding, but... My dolly's got 31% damage. How in the hell does that happen when the two trailers don't have that much? Okay, this guy right here, he's really hurt. I got to get him to the shop, and then I got to get to work. I got to get to work. So, the cows need straw, I know that. Wow, this thing is wide. Oh, what a monster, huh? Just in case you've got, haven't seen this. I've had this mod for quite some time, just haven't used it. It's this Horsch right here, 27, I don't know what the 27 meters, I'm guessing. Yeah, 27 meters. So anyway, I've had this for quite some time. This one's pretty good too, but it's not very big. It's only 10 meters. This one's completely unrealistic, and it's you get what you pay for. It's nothing. All right, see if we can get this guy to the shop. This guy, he's not even going to fit on the rack. This thing is huge. I'm going to get damaged just getting there. I don't know how this guy took so much damage. Unless it's my driving. That could be. And see, am I going to take damage going over this curb? Because how are you going to get in there without driving over the curb? Alright, let me see if I can get on here without hitting the rack. Oh, I can get on there. Alright. Let's jump out of here. Now, has that got the tractor or the piece of equipment on it? Okay, the horse tie. See, it doesn't have the tractor. That's okay, we'll do it separate. I don't know if I can do them together. Yeah, you can. Look at that. Oh, that makes a difference. There's two stations here. Well, cool. All right, we'll start him, and then we'll start him. You love those sounds. Clang, ding, woo. Sounds like money to me. All right, let me see. What do we want to do first? Okay, I tell you what I want to do first. What I want to do first is I want to check... Because I can't remember what I seeded. There it was. Or did I even seed? Maybe I haven't seeded yet. Oh my God. I haven't seeded yet. Well, that's good. That's good. Because I changed my mind on what I was going to seed. I want to do some sugar beets. So I think I'm going to do this big one here. Oh, talking about sugar beets. I went to show you this before. I do have the new DLC. And I didn't know what to do with it. I didn't know whether to spend the money on it or not, but I did. And I don't even know what it is for sure. This Holmer stuff. I'm assuming this is sugar beet equipment. So, I've got this here and this thing. And I don't know what they do. I'm going to have to try them. I don't know if this takes the heads off the beets or if this... digs the beets up, because on sugar beets you have, you know, the top you're supposed to cut off and before you can dig them up. So I've got that Holmer thing, and comes with something else too. I can't remember what. Let's see. Not that. Oh, I know. I can go to brand names and go to Holmer and find out. Okay, so you get this thing, which it's kind of interesting because, well, let's see what this is. An auger wagon, also known as chaser bins, are trailers that have their own screw conveyor. You can use them to store your crop and directly unload into other vehicles. Cool. So, what the hell does that mean? Is this an overloader? Is that what that is? Because that's what an overloader is an auger wagon. So, evidently, this thing backs onto that thing. And then these things also. So then this is a sugar beet tank. What the hell does that mean? I don't know. It's another auger wagon. So you can store, yeah. So there's two auger wagons. Okay, this one we can use for wheat, barley, canola. I know it's canola. Corn and chafe. So it's kind of like a regular overloader in a way. This one only does beets. And then, of course, you have that we already saw, and that, and then a trailer. The trailer must be for this, I guess. Although that's not very wide, so I don't know why you'd use a trailer. But I want to try this stuff since I paid umpteen bucks for the DLC. And then after I found out it was all to do with sugar beets, not completely. This one's not necessarily sugar beets. But, yeah, I kind of wondered after I bought it, why I bought it and never use it. So now I have to do sugar beets. All right. I know I'm rambling. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Oh, good Lord. Too late. All right, so we need to get our cedars going. It's a potato washer. Potatoes washed, mixing tank full. Okay. All right. Okay, fine. We need to get our cedars going. So, let's see what we got here. Let's go fill this thing up. I need to wash my equipment, too. It's filthy. So, let's see. We're going to... I just need to decide. I think I'm going to do, well, I don't know. Should I do a great big field of sugar beets, or should I start with a small one? I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I was using 18 for potatoes. So I think I'll use 18 for sugar beets too. And then we'll just see how it works. Oh, these are backwards from what they were. So I need to do, because I used to be able just to pull in and get what I needed. Now I got to do it backwards. I just have to remember that. Oh, crap. I was right the first time. Never mind. Oh, God. Too early in the morning. I played this damn farm all day yesterday trying to get it caught up. It takes forever. It's amazing how much work you do in just a few episodes. Okay, my canoodle is done. Oh boy, I shouldn't have said that. All right, let's fill this thing up with fertilizer, fill it up with seeds. I guess it was almost full to begin with. Filthy dirty too. I need to wash it. I haven't bought a washer yet. I'm guessing I'll keep it where I kept the other one, close to the farmhouse. It's the only real straight area that I can just kind of pull into. So I think I'm going to put it right here again where I had it before. So let's go do some sugar beets. Run up to field 18. Start that process. The sheep productivity is 15%. The cows are at 15%. Not bad considering I haven't fed or watered them. Well, I've watered them. I haven't fed either one. Hmm. Okay, where am I going? I don't know. Stuff right there. Okay, we need to grab a course. We're gonna do seating, and it's going to be seed fields in Roy. That one right there. Oh, we're almost lined up. Good deal. And we got beats on. We got our beats on this morning. All right, I'll let that guy go. And what was I saying before I started that? I got equipment in the way. Oh, the canoodle's done. Well, what about the other thing? Is it done too? It must be. Yep, it's all fixed. It's just dirty now. I wonder if dirt causes damage. You know what? I'm just going to leave him sitting here for now. They can charge me rent for taking up parking spaces. I did get another tractor. Scorpion's Edge sent me a link to a tractor, a John Deere, because I keep complaining about that John Deere I have. It's a hate-love relationship. It's a deer. It's a John Deere, so I love it, but it's kind of a weird mod, so I hate it. This one here, the 4755, is just a lightweight. It's only 190 horsepower. He says he got it just because of the sound. So I'm gonna get it just for a extra tractor, even just a placemaker. But let's see, where's it at? Right behind me here. Let me get out of this. Run around. Look at this now. The 4755. It looks like kind of a nice used tractor, you know. Just a workhorse. That's all it is, really. Interesting. I wonder what that grate thing there's for, so you don't burn your fingers when you accidentally stick your hand in here. Okay, now this is why he says he bought this tractor. Listen to it. He says he loves the sound. Says it reminds him of Snagglepuss. Does anybody remember Snagglepuss? It was a cartoon. A cat. Was that the guy that... Snagglepuss, was he the one that used to say... Well, no, I can't remember. Never mind. Exit stage left. No, that wasn't him. Anyway, it sounds kind of cool, and it's got black smoke. I love tractors that have black smoke. I don't know what I'm going to use it for, so right now I'm just going to kind of park it right here. I don't think it's strong enough for that cedar. It does sound pretty cool. Let's see, what does it look like inside? Ooh, I can almost... Oh, I'm headless! Oh my god, but my hat's still on. That's weird. You want to see something weird? I'll show you something weird. Let's go to the Superman truck and go inside. What? Where am I? Where's my windshield? It's upside down. Look, we're hanging from the ceiling. Well, what? Yeah, that's weird. All right, I guess I can't drive my truck from the inside anymore like I used to. I gotta find a spare tractor here. Let me turn that one off. I'm wasting fuel. Okay, let's see. We can use this guy. Go seed another field. Remember what Snagglepuss used to do. There used to be one of them that's suffering succotash, but I think that's the one that was always after the Tweety Bird. I can't remember. It's been so long since I've watched cartoons. Well, outside of South Park or something like that. This piece of equipment going. Yeah, no, you know, I have to be careful. Normally, I would come rushing in here, just slam into it, hook it up, but no, I've got to drive respectfully. I got to be a cautious driver now. All right, we're full up. Let's just start with field 11, I guess. Doesn't really matter. I don't know what to do, though. First of all, let's see what we have in our grain bins. Okay, we do have... Well, how do we get cotton? Must we come with the farm? Oh, my God. Are you kidding? All right. How's this working? Oh, it's on the bottom. Okay. So I have mostly wheat. I don't have cotton, do I? No, sunflowers on the top, cotton, rape, wheat, okay, seeds, I have seeds, soybeans, maize, but mostly I just have wheat, so I can do anything I want. I don't know what I should do though. What should I do? What should I do? I need to do some more corn, so I don't know where to do the corn, though. Corn. I think I'll do the corn on 17, and then I'll do, let's do the corn on 17. All right, this is field 11. We're going to be seeding. Let's do, oh, goodness gracious. What should we do? Seed the field. Let's do something different. We're going to do field 11. Go back here. And then, let's see. Pull the cedar up. We've got canola, grass, corn, sugar beets, taters. Uh-oh. Do I have the other one set on sugar beets? Where is it? Oh, I do. Oh, I could have looked up here. Silly me. All right, so hey, sugar beets doesn't take the seeds that potatoes do, evidently. All right, let me see where I've got all these things. Unassigned. Let's put this up in 3. I'll put my tractors in 3. 4, Superman, 5. Let's put tractors in 6. The ones I'm not using for overloaders. And then, let's see, we'll put this one in 6. Oh, I'm putting them in 7. Never mind. That's okay, too. So... let me get this guy going. Okay, so he's gonna do... what did we decide? We didn't make a decision, did we? Soybeans. I like soybeans. Let's do soybeans. Why not? Alright, and then this guy is doing... he's got the other... okay, he's got the other, I'll leave him there for now. This one, we need 4 sugar beets, maybe. Let's get him started, though. Where is he? He's in 3. I'm confused. Where am I? Okay, yeah, I need to do some work with him. We need to do Something was full. What was full? I thought they said the potato thing was full. I'll go look. Okay, diesel's okay, the seeds are okay, the water's okay. Compost is only 19%, so that's okay. Which one's needing assistance? 92, 28, 85, compost. It's the same. I don't know. That didn't make any sense. Okay. So we got both our cedars going. I need to buy some mods. Somebody was giving me a hard time. Not a hard time. Somebody asked me why I used unrealistic equipment. And basically that was what they asked me. Why do you use unrealistic equipment? Well, how do you respond to that? So I thought about it. And at first I thought, you know, I don't have to answer every comment. I know some YouTubers that don't answer any comments. As a matter of fact, I know YouTubers that never read their comments. So, but that's not much fun, is it? Anyway, so I decided I could either just ignore it or whatever, but I decided now I'm going to answer it. So how do you answer, you know, that kind of a question? I just said, hey, it's a game, and it's fun. That's it. Why do I use unrealistic equipment? I don't know if he's talking about these things or if he was talking about the really fast combines I have, which I don't use very often. Uh-oh, wait a minute. I can't leave the store without the rest of this. So I don't know if he's talking about these or if he's talking about the combines, but whatever. It's fun. It's fun to use. It's a game. So, you know. All right, I need two of these. I'm going to make one green. And I'm going to make one red, just like I used to do. And then I need a couple of weights. Buy one of those, and let's buy another one of those. And then let's fix these things up. Okay, now it seemed to me like it was easier to put the weight on first. Because the last time I picked up the fraises, and I had trouble with it because I didn't have enough weight. So let me pick up a weight first. And put some weights on it. This is thing one. Thing one was always green in the past, so thing one it is. Oh God, can you imagine now that I have damage if I drive this thing? See, I've already got 5% damage on it. I haven't done anything. Come on. What did I do to get 5% damage? Have you seen me drive these things? I can't go through shortcuts and hit trees and fly over hills and dales and... Oh, man. You take all my fun away. I guess I can still do it, but the rig's going to be ruined. When I first started the map, I didn't realize there was damage on it. And I'm just running through my shortcuts like I always do. And I got to the field I was going to. And because I had flown, you know, from this farm to the south farm, or the north farm, 90 miles an hour, jumping logs and trees and stuff, I get there, I get to the field, and I start to use the piece of equipment. It says, you can't use the piece of equipment, it's too damaged. I said, what? What? Then I looked down in the corner and I said, what is that? Oh my God. So I went back to the shop. I was wondering at the shop what those two pieces of equipment were on the side of the building. I had no clue. So I figured, you know what? They've got whatchadingers on them. They've got that black and yellow tape on them. So they must do something. And I drove on one, and it said, hey, you can repair your equipment. Oh, that's what that's all about. After I got done crying, I went ahead and repaired it and got back out in the field. Let's put this in number one with my pick-em-up truck. Go get the other one. Put him in one. And now see, he's got 1% damage and all I did was get in it. How did that happen? I know how that happened. You know how it happened? You know when you buy a piece of equipment and it drops out of the sky? That's how I got 1% damage. You want to bet? It wasn't even my fault. It was the damn game. Good thing these things don't cost anything. $100. All right, let's whoop around here. Pick up the thing number two's equipment. I didn't have enough chaff to have silage running on both farms. So I got the one on the main farm was completely full, and I can't remember what percent the one on the south farm was. We'll run down to the south farm and get that going while the seeding is going. I haven't noticed any staggering or stuttering or anything with that. As you know, I have a high-end computer. It should handle just about anything. But it doesn't handle this game that well. I have two problems. One of them is screen tearing. And I did everything that Giant said to do to fix the screen tearing, but it didn't completely fix it. So what I do to try to lessen that is, And it helps quite a little bit, because boy, it was screen tearing yesterday. It was just about every 30 seconds I'd get a big screen tear. The screen tearing doesn't bother me as much as the stuttering or the jumping of the video. I'm getting good frame rates. That's not the problem. I got excellent frame rates. I just get the darn screen tearing. One of the problems is my recording equipment causes part of it, because it's a software. So I'm using my NVIDIA graphics card to record this game. So it doesn't use the CPU. It uses the graphics capabilities. The other thing I do is I go to Steam and put it on offline mode. That seems to help. So those are the two things I do to try to mitigate my issues with screen tearing. And it seems to help. It doesn't happen too often. Oh, the third thing I do, I have dual monitors. I turn one of the monitors off. I just run one monitor while I'm recording in this particular game. So those things do help. I thought it was kind of interesting, because when you go to Giant and you start looking at the forums and stuff, they claim that they know there's an issue and that it happens to be with high-end computers. Isn't that weird? You'd purchase a computer, a high-end computer, so that you could run just about anything with no issues. Well, it doesn't work that way, does it? All right, let's see. I gotta really be careful. I can't, normally I'd just gun that thing and you know, jam the pedal down to the metal, and I can't do that anymore because I'm gonna take damage. damage if I do. Wait a minute. Oh, geez. See what I mean? Oh, I'm in the chaff. Oh, man. I did... Oh, gotta watch that all the time now. I just did 8% damage. I damaged my weights, and I didn't even hit the weights. This is gonna be awful. Oh, just awful. My equipment's gonna be lined up for 3 miles to the repair station. I wonder if there's a repair station mod that you can stick in yourself. I might have to do that if I can find one. How's this guy doing? He's 100%. Let's go turn him off, raise him up. Be careful going over the bumps. You're gonna take damage. I do like that the barns were switched around too. It makes more sense now. You can just drive through and right side, left side, whichever you need. Right through here. This is cool right here. I got equipment in the way. Don't hit it. Don't hit it. Oh, don't do that. Yeah. Yep. I used to just run through the farm willy-nilly. Is that how the weight got hurt when it hit the ground like that? Can't figure out how the weight got hurt. All right, let's see. I need to get, where's that one that's in the way? One of these was in the way, this one here. Let's get him and look, it's got silage in it. You've messed me up. Now there's only 0% silage, so all I have to do is pull into whatever I want and it'll replace it. What do I want, though? I want straw. I'm gonna go put straw in the cow bedding. Whoop. Come on, give me some straw. That used to do that. Come on, there it goes. All right. Yeah, if you have less than 1 or 2% in your trailer, I can't remember. It's either 3, 2, or 1. If it's less than 2, less than 3, and you pull into something else, it'll go ahead and replace whatever was in there. If you have like 4 or 5%, too bad. You have to empty it out. So yeah, we're going to give the animals some bedding. I think I gave the chickens and the pigs bedding. Let's see. I know I didn't do the milk cows. And I can't remember if I did the other cattle. What do I have anyway? I got pigs, chickens. Okay, there's sheep, fattened cows, fattened chickens, and piggies, and beef. All right. So the pigs, straw. Yeah, pigs have straw. Beef did not get straw. I think the chickens did. Fattening cows didn't get straw. Chickens did get straw. Chicken and biscuits. Now wait a minute. I gave the sheep straw. Oh. The sheep must be on the other farm, the north farm. Is it full yet? I don't know if it has to be full, but I don't want to come back if I don't need to. Alright. Don't hit a tree. Don't hit grass. Don't hit your mother-in-law. I missed the swoosh. I get this Windows 10. Where's my swoosh? Come on. The swoosh scared the hell out of me all this time. Wait a minute. Windows 10 scares the hell out of me too, so maybe that is appropriate. Alright, well, you know what that means. I've been yapping too long, so let's see if I can fill this thing up. I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode. When we come back, we'll continue on with our trying to get caught up. I guess there's really no trying to get caught up. We're just farming on a new map. I hope Stevie doesn't change it too soon. Okay, so I'll see you in the next episode. Hope you're having fun and happy farming.